This book asks important questions, such as how would a society work if zombies were real, few in numbers, not out of their mind with hunger, and instead functioning members of said society? And what woman wouldn't want to be clothed in singing jeweled butterflies? Me, thanks for asking. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Kat, and today I would like to talk about Manners and Monsters by Tilly Wallace. Hannah, a borderline spinster at 22 in 1816, helps her father research the condition known as altered, which was caused by a particularly insidious trap by French mages who hid a spell in face powder, which then turned women who came into contact with it into zombies. Society has adapted to make space for them and have them live in their midst. While they do need human brains to sustain themselves, if they follow a decent diet, they can make do with one brain in a month, roughly. And luckily, since society has adapted, people get paid if a relative dies and then just vanishes for an hour or two while their brain gets removed, which is then sold as pickled cauliflower to said zombies. One brain a month is enough unless they partake in gluttony, which one of them does at Hannah's friend's engagement party. Then Hannah is asked to help the investigating officer because she's an expert in the field. I really enjoyed this book, and there are only like one or two rather minor things. And one of them isn't even appearing in this book, it just looks like it might come further down the line. But I'll see when I get there, because I already bought the whole collection. The two POVs you get to see in this book are A from Hannah and Lord Wycliffe, the investigating officer. They are both great characters to follow because the chemistry between them works out rather well. So Hannah is clearly a smart woman who sticks to society's conventions where necessary to get through, who really cares about just about everybody she encounters, unless they really give her a reason to dislike them, which only counts for like one or two characters in the whole book. And Lord Wycliffe is super grouchy, doesn't give a shit about any conventions, will just barge into homes and accuse people of murder outright, and yeah, they have a good chemistry going. None of the side characters felt flat to me either, especially Hannah's parents. You don't get to see much of her best friend yet, which I think is also a dedication to Jane Austen novels, but you don't get to see much of Lizzie yet. I imagine you get to meet her a couple more times in the next few books. But yeah, even though you only see her for a couple of pages, she doesn't feel flat either, just like she fades into the background a bit because she doesn't do much in this book yet. I imagine she will be helpful further down the line. The world building is great, and a lot of thought has been put into how this disease would affect society in that time in England and how people would cope with it. The world also features other supernatural beings, but we don't get to see any of them yet. We hear about werewolves at some point, and there's also magic. We don't know how that works yet either, but I hope you will get to see more of it in the next books, because Hannah's mom is also investigating magic to see whether it can help cure the disease, as she is a mage herself. There are hints of a romance to come. Lord Wycliffe doesn't think much of women. He is quite a misogynistic ass at points. But over time he comes to realize, okay, Hannah is smarter than your average woman. Or like the average woman as he perceives them, at least. And he comes around to respect her and actually value her opinion. But that's only for one woman, and it would be nice to see a bit more of that. Maybe, you know, be a little less misogynistic. So while she is rather upset with him most of the time because of his behavior, she doesn't quite understand that she's attracted to him yet, but some other characters pick up on it. But she also knows that after she hears that he has some tragic backstory that she doesn't know any details about, she kind of construes the more tragedy into it than she's aware of, but at least she recognizes that she's making this up herself until she gets to know what actually happened in his past. And seeing how stubborn she is, she will poke around until she gets to learn about it. Yes, that's the one con, I guess. If misogyny annoys the shit out of you, then this might not be the book for you. I mean, Hannah is doing her best to go against the grain and take up space in, you know, in an area that's usually not for women in that time and era, but, you know, if fighting against men pushing her back annoys you, then this might be set in the wrong era for you. Also, some info gets repeated. It's between like Lizzie telling her something in dialogue, and then two pages further down, Hannah repeats it as a thought, and you're like, yeah, I remember what happened 2 pages ago, thank you. It only pops up in a couple of places, and it's not massively annoying or anything. It was just, it stood out enough for me to notice. As a random side note, I'm still laughing about the name Sir General Manly Powers. I mean, Manly Powers? I don't know whether that's actually like an old-fashioned first name for a guy in Britain at some point. Not as far as I know or as far as I've seen. But General Manly Powers. Yes, all those Manly Powers combined in one dude. Overall, I'm really happy I picked this up. I like reading about zombies. I like reading cozy mysteries. So this was a brilliant combination for me. And like I said, I already bought the whole collection. And whenever I have the time for it, I will go through all of it. Looking forward to it. So overall, it deserves this cat. And I can't wait to return to Hannah, if only my TBR list wasn't this long. Hopefully soon. Let me know in the comments how worried you would be if zombies were a thing and part of society. As they are depicted here, I don't think I would be too worried, to be honest. Apart from the smell. Because that's not pretty. Anyway, like and subscribe if you want to help this channel out, and thank you guys for watching. I'll be back next week with another video. Bye guys!